G'day there, Pete Moriarty here. Google have updated their Hangouts and relaunched it as Google Meet. Now, this was originally relaunched a year or so ago, but now with the coronavirus and the current economic situation, Google are actually making this available to everyone who has a G Suite account, and you're getting some of the upgraded enterprise options that not everyone had available previously. And so Google Meet is the new place to go to do meetings, video calls, anything, connect with your team in your business, outside your business as well, if you are in the Google ecosystem. Now, there are other tools out there like Zoom. There's, of course, Skype and all of Microsoft's stuff as well. But Google Meet is really the easiest and simplest to use if you're already using the Google ecosystem. It's heavily integrated with the rest of the Google world, like Hangouts Chat, their chat program, which is a bit like Slack, and it talks to your calendar, which is really nice as well. Works across all devices, works in the browser with no downloads and no security concerns. So Google Meet is our recommendation and we love it, use it internally all the time. So let's go ahead and dig into getting access to the enterprise features of Google Meet and most importantly, recording your meets, because this is really one of the best features that has been on the enterprise plan that has not yet been available for the basic and the business plans. So first up, you need to jump into your admin console and inside your admin console, you go to apps, and then yours will say there Google Meet. Mine currently says, whoops, first you need to go into G Suite. And then yours will say Google Meet here. Now, right now, mine still says Hangouts, I think, because I've got a partner account and it's a bit weird. But basically, once you go on to that and you switch it on for everyone, it's going to give you access to Google Meet. Now, you also have some other settings here, like whether or not you want to allow people to record, whether or not you want to allow people to stream their meetings. The streaming feature is okay, but for the most part, you want to make sure that recording is switched on so everybody can access recording and do that. So once you've done that, then it's just a matter of jumping into a meet and actually hitting record. Now, one of my favorite ways to jump in and create a meet and actually share that with other team members is to first start with a calendar event, because many times when you're going to be meeting with someone on your team, you're probably going to have a scheduled meeting of some sort. So to do that, we're going to jump into our calendar. And inside our calendar, if I go and create a test meeting here, let's say test, as soon as I add at least one guest, it's automatically going to drop a meet in there. And so you can see it's added a URL. I've got my Hangouts meeting, and also, you know, when I added that person, it's brought up their calendar as well. So that makes things nice and simple. It means that you're automatically going to have a meet anytime that you have a meeting with someone. Or if you don't, even if you don't have someone in there, it'll start out without anything there, and you can click Add Conferencing and add a meet there, and it's going to go ahead and add it. Now, you can customize the options here. You've got dial-in numbers and things like that, which is pretty handy if someone wants to join via the phone. And the live stream feature there is there as well. So if you've got more than 250 people, you can switch to the live stream feature. If you've got less than 250 people, though, you can just use a Meet meeting, which is nice and simple. So once you've got that set up, the next thing is to actually jump into the meeting. Many people don't know this, but you can actually go to meet.google.com. And inside meet.google.com, you've got like this really cool little splash page. And on this splash page, it shows you all of your upcoming meetings that you have for the day. So you can see I've got a current meeting there and any additional meetings that are upcoming. And with one click, I can actually jump straight into those. Now, if I was to actually save that test meeting there, that will pretty much instantly pop up here on my Google Meet. There we go, it's popped up already. And I can jump straight into the test meeting. Now, before I join, gives me a little preview here, which is pretty groovy. And that kind of lets me know that I'm about to jump into the meeting, lets me adjust and make sure that I look pretty, which is pretty cool. And then when I can, if I want, I can just present to the meeting, but I'm gonna go ahead and join in here. And so you can see what it looks like here. It's just me in this meeting. And so it's just showing my video, but normally I'd see other people's video in here. So now that we're in the meeting, let's have a look at the recording options. And so you will have a menu option added when you have the ability to record in the little menu down here. So bottom right-hand corner, I click onto record meeting. And when I click record meeting, it's gonna basically ask, it's not necessarily gonna ask for their permission, but it's gonna notify everyone in the meeting that it's actually being recorded. So it is prompting me to ask them. And then once I click accept, takes a couple of seconds, and then it's going to start recording, and that's all you have to do. The great thing is if you leave the meeting or your computer crashes or your internet drops out, the recording is no longer dependent on your individual connection. You hear that little bing to let you know that it's actually started. Once you've actually started the recording, you can leave the meeting, and as long as there are still other people active in the meeting, the recording will continue, and the recording will only finish when Google deems the meeting to be finished, which means when the expired time has elapsed and everyone has left the meeting. So this is now recording, And not only will it record my screen and my video, but it will record everyone else as well. Now, it doesn't really matter how you have the layout set up, if you've got everyone in a grid view, or if you're using one of those plugins that makes everyone into, you know, a larger grid, similar to Zoom's gallery view. It's still basically just going to record what's happening in the meeting and who is speaking. And so the highlighted speaker will be in the recording, and then it'll have their name down the bottom as well. So if you want to do like a professional recording that you want to produce or share somewhere, then you want to make sure that people have their names set up correctly in G Suite and everything else. So once the recording is done, I can choose to click stop manually if I like, and that'll actually stop the recording. And if I choose to record a second time, it'll create a second recording, and each one of these files will be separate files. You can create as many as you want, and there's no limit. If you are on G Suite Basic, it will start to consume your Google Drive storage space, so just be mindful of that. But if you're on G Suite Business or G Suite Enterprise, you get unlimited storage, and then it's never really going to be a concern how much you use. So let me show you where the recordings go after you've actually got the recordings done. I'm going to jump into my Google Drive here, and if you go first to your My Drive, then you'll see there is actually a folder here called Meet Recordings. And so in Meet Recordings, I've got one that I did earlier today. The one that I just recorded will happen shortly. And you'll see here that where you have a name on your meetings, you will actually get the meeting name on the recording name, which makes it nice and easy. But apart from that, if you've just started an impromptu meeting or just started recording on an impromptu basis, then you'll just get the meeting ID, which will show up there, but at least you do get the date in there as well, which makes it nice and easy to identify. Now, after they've been in this folder for a little bit, just like all video files, you can actually preview and play them inside Google Drive. So this is an earlier recording that I did with our team earlier today. And it's actually, you can see there, I'll mute the audio there, but you can actually see what it looks like. So when different people are talking, it'll actually show their name down the bottom, and just the highlighted speaker is going to be highlighted in the recording. Now, you may have also noticed some text files here as well. The text files basically capture the chat. So if there's any chatter happening in the room inside of Meet, it'll actually capture those and put them into a text document as well, so you've got all of that captured. Now, what I like to do if I've got a meet, and for example, this one I need to put into the content folder for the recording that I made earlier. After I've gone into the Meet Recordings folder here, I can move this to another folder. And so in my case, I'm producing a video and I want to put this into the project folder. I can go straight along to my team drives here, or now called shared drives, previously team drives, and I can find the right folder that I need to move it into. Let's go ahead and pop that in there, and then I can click one button and move that file in. Now, after you've created your meet and you've got everybody on board in the meeting and you've recorded the meeting, after that recording is finished, it's actually going to be shared with everyone who was on the meeting. So just keep in mind, if you are recording and you stick around after someone has dropped off, well, that full recording is going to be shared with anyone who was on the meet. That's a little trap for new players there. So when someone leaves, just make sure you save the bad mouthing till after you've stopped the recording. But that's the recording. It's pretty simple. And we use this all the time. We record pretty much every meeting that we have inside the business. Unfortunately, there's no way to automate the recording based on Google being really concerned about privacy and, you know, business owners needing to make sure that they are keeping the privacy secure of everyone who's involved in meetings, whether they're inside your company or outside your company. There's no way to automatically have every meeting recorded, although that is a popular request. I don't know of any third-party plugins or integrations that do that so far, but we'll let you know if we find any. Hopefully this has been helpful, showing you how to get recordings happening inside Meet. If this is not yet switched on for your account or you don't have access to it, then reach out to our team at itGenius. We can help you out getting it set up for your account. If you're not yet a member of our concierge program, then please make sure to check that out. We have online recordings, an amazing community of other business owners who are using G Suite, and we have a full private training video library. It's called Genius Academy, to show you and your team how to get the most out of G Suite. We run regular live webinars all the time, covering everything to do with the Google ecosystem. And if you haven't had a chance to check any of our content out, head along to itgenius.com or head along to our YouTube channel. Check out everything that's happening there. And until next time, we'll see you in the next video. Take care. Cheers.